governor's budget dealing with locals?
Well, my first reaction was it could have been a lot worse. So, you know, I don't love it, and I don't think any of the counties love it, but there was a lot of talk about shifting teacher pension costs down to counties, which would have been, you know, hundreds of millions of dollars of cost to counties as opposed to, you know, the $60 million. I mean, we've taken big hits. I mean, the highway user funds that go to counties have been cut about $350 million a year now for the third straight year. So when you say level funding, it sounds, you know, not so bad. But when it's level funding off a 95% cut the year before, then it's not so good. So there's a proposal to shift the cost of the property tax assessment offices, which are state offices, but most of the revenue goes to counties. That makes up a big chunk of the $50 or $60 million to counties. But it certainly could have been worse. And, you know, I was just up in New York meeting with the rating agencies. We're AAA bond rated from all three agencies, and we guard that rating. We were up there the last couple of days, and I was reading the New York papers. And, man, that made me appreciate being in Maryland. As tough as we have it, they're talking about firing tens of thousands of teachers.
Oh, Governor Cuomo has come out right away and said that's what they're going to do.
And so, you know, they're talking New York City saying, you know, we got to fire, you know, 10,000 teachers. And so, you know, we got tough challenges here, but we're up to them. We've been making them for the last, you know, number of years through this recession, and we'll keep doing it.
When you talk about the potential shift, which is not on apparently for this year, of teacher pensions and a 50-50 kind of split between state and locals, President of the Senate Mike Miller is saying, well, that's not a reality this year. It's going to become a reality. How do you look down the road at dealing with the whole issue of teacher pensions, all these pension obligations all jurisdictions are having that are really problematic down the road?
Sure. And, you know, I have a lot of respect for the Senate president. We just don't agree on this issue. But he certainly, you know, the bill passed the Senate last time. Our mantra from counties has been fix the system before you shift any cost. So if you address the sustainability of the system, then, you know, we'd be much more willing to engage in a discussion about cost sharing. We don't want to have any of it shift, but it's really a difficult issue. You know, the local boards of education negotiate with the teachers union. Then the state sets the pension benefit and manages the pension fund. So I, as county executive, have no role in that equation whatsoever, except being asked to write the check. And so that there's a great frustration amongst county leaders to say, wait a second. You know, I've got a general fund now where 62% of my general fund goes to the Board of Education. I love Howard County Public Schools. They're the driver of our county. My kids go to great public schools. I went to great public schools, graduating from Centennial High School in Howard County. But with that said, that's 62% that I don't have as much leverage over as I would like. And that squeeze can't continue where I'm cutting every other area of my budget and education is held harmless. So we got to have a further discussion about that. And frankly, I think the governor did a good job of putting some pension cuts and sustainability of the system on the table. And the legislature is going to have to grapple with it, and we'll see where it goes.